I did not cry as a child because I knew that her death was not in vain. And I knew that we would have the right to vote. I was 5 years old, and I remember her funeral, and I can still see it, you know, to this day. We were in the church, and I was standing with my cousin, Luther, and I asked him, could I go see my great-grandmother? Because I wanted to say goodbye to her and to thank her for what she did. And my cousin held my hand, and I could see tears running down his eyes. He said that, you can't. My great-grandmother, her name was Birdia Keglar. She was a civil rights activist. She lived in Charleston, Mississippi. She became active in the voter registration drive. Stokely Carmichael brought a white college student from Boston, Massachusetts, and the college student worked with my great-grandmother. January of 1966, went to give a testimony with Senator Robert Kennedy. She gave a testimony of how she tried to register people to vote, but the sheriff denied her. After the hearing, she told Senator Robert Kennedy that she had received death threats. On her way back home from giving the testimony, the Klan ran them off the road. My great-grandmother was beaten and she was decapitated for registering people to vote. I knew that her death was not in vain, and I knew that we would have the right to vote. And I made sure that my family voted, and then when I turned 18, I voted, and I've been voting ever since. When I found out that Bernie participated in the sit-ins, that he was one of those students that believed in the same dreams that my great-grandmother believed in, and that he was out there fighting. He had the courage where a lot of people didn't step out to help. And then when I found out he was SNCC, I think about how my great-grandmother, the last person that was in the car with her, was the 27-year-old SNCC student. And I think about if she was alive today, that student would be the same age as Bernie Sanders. As far as Black Lives Matter, he was there with us in the 60s. He was there for us, and I want to be there for him. I know if he's elected, he will focus on the racial injustice. He's the only candidate that will unite all of us. He's not just talking the talk to get elected. That's him. It's been in him since the 60s. Participate in the political revolution, but make sure people get out to vote.